Like in the case of contours, a prerequisite for drawing tools and measurements to work is an ortho projection in one 2D view. As before, the tools can be found in the ortho 2D tools. To activate them, we will click on Measure. Now the drawing tools are active. Before we move on to volume and area calculations, let's get familiarized with the basics of drawing tools. We can pick from a number of drawing tools. My favorite is the polygon because it can be easily edited. We will go over editing in just a bit. To start drawing, just left click with the mouse. Additional vertices are also drawn with the left mouse button, so we'll continue to create a polygon around this entire pile. If we make a mistake, we can remove the last vertex using the right mouse button. To cancel the entire drawing, press Escape, and to close the shape, we have three options. Move the mouse cursor near the first vertex, it will snap to it, and now we can just left click to close the shape. Instead of snapping to the first vertex, we can snap to the last vertex and again close the shape with the left mouse button. Or we can just double click to place the last vertex and close the shape. After we close the shape, a new panel appeared in the 1DS and a new 2D view appeared displaying the height profile along the boundary of the shape. We will check them in a while. Let's draw another shape with the brush. We can draw with it and change the size of the brush like in other photo editing software using the square brackets on the keyboard. We can also use it with modifiers on selected regions. Hold down Ctrl to add to the region, a small plus sign is visible in the brush, or hold down Shift to subtract from the region and a small minus is visible in the brush. Shapes like polygon, polyline and the freeform shape can also be edited. Let's quickly draw another polygon. Now let's disable Measure and let's enable Edit Region. I can select multiple polygons and edit them all at once. Let's select the second one by holding down Ctrl and clicking on it. There are two options how to select vertices. First option is to simply click on them. We will see that it is highlighted. To select additional vertices, hold down the Ctrl key and left click on multiple vertices. We can also select vertices from another polygon if it is selected. The Shift key can be used to remove vertices from the selection. Another method of selecting vertices is using one of the drawing tools. In this case, only the vertices will be selected and no new shapes will be created. Let's try the freeform shape. Now we can move the entire selection of vertices by clicking in proximity of one of them and dragging the entire selection like this. Selected vertices can also be deleted with the delete key. To add new vertices, we need to get close to an existing edge and press the left mouse button. Before we move on to volumes and area measurements, we need to take a look at snapping. Snapping is done by holding the left Alt key. Let's start drawing a new polygon. With the pressed left Alt key, the mouse cursor will now snap horizontally or vertically. It can also snap to control points, to vertices, or edges of existing regions. Finally, it can snap perpendicular to the last segment. All of the snapping options can be controlled in the snapping panel that can be turned on here. By default, all of the options are turned on. Definitely try to play with all of the drawing tools. And now let's move on to measurements. When I finished the first polygon, I mentioned that a new panel opened in the 1DS. Let's select the polygon and get back to it. In the panel, we can see the name of the region and its color. Both can be changed if we want to. Next, we have the volume info and area info. The area info is self-explanatory. It contains the calculated 2D area and 3D area. The volume is calculated with respect to something we call the base plane. Everything above the base plane is considered as part of the cut volume. Everything that is below the base plane is considered as part of the fill volume. There is an option to visualize the base plane in 3D, so let's open the 3D view and change the rendering to vertices. Currently, the base plane type is set to interpolated, and we can see that the base plane is pretty reasonable in this case. There are multiple options for the base plane. Each method has its pros and cons, so they are suited for various situations. When it is set to none, the volume will not be calculated. This is good if you want only the calculated area or to edit the region, but you don't want to recalculate the region every time you move a single vertex because it takes some computer resources. Interpolated creates a base surface by interpolating the terrain in the selected shape. Flat and minimum and maximum height method has two base planes. The bottom plane is at the lowest point of the shape boundary, and the top plane is at the highest point of the shape boundary. Based on this, the cut volume is calculated from the bottom plane to the surface of the model, and the fill volume from the top plane to the surface of the model. We can see that in this case, the bottom plane doesn't suit us because the surface is sloped. Sometimes we do not want the top or the bottom, but manually specify the height. That is exactly what flat at user-defined height enables us to do. It works amazingly well with the height profile, where you can get the height of any point along the boundary. Finally, there is the best fit plane. The best fit plane uses linear regression to calculate a flat plane from the boundary of the shape. It's time to take a look at the height profile. Let's switch the right view to 2D to display the profile, and let's enable and select this line number 1. The height profile has two axes, position along the boundary and height. Right now, their scale is 1:1, but we can change the scale of the height with the mouse scroll wheel, like this. Notice that when we move the mouse cursor over the height profile, we can also see a cross moving along the line in the left 2D view. Simultaneously, the height profile shows the exact position and height of the cross. Just a couple of notes before moving on. It is possible to select multiple regions to get the sum of the volumes and areas. Regions also work with color cursors. They are part of the selected orthoprojection report, and they can be shared between projects same as the reconstruction region using the export shapes and import shapes options.